friends, come on in, take your shoes off, have a seat, and consider staying a while by clicking that subscribe button. Friday, everyone. I am so happy this week is over. It's just been very chaotic, and I don't know about you, but I am excited for the weekend. We are taking our first camping trip this weekend, and I'm just so excited to get away. But last week I posted a video on baby's bug out bag, and I had a lot of you message me asking me, what are we stockpiling for our unborn child? So I am currently 6 months pregnant, almost 7 months pregnant. And so obviously as a new mom, I am just worrying about everything, and, we are stockpiling for ourselves, and my number one priority now is my son. And I want to make sure that if something were to happen, we could fully take care of him and not have to worry. So yes, I have started stockpiling for him even this early. In this video, I thought I would share the items that we have started to stockpile to hopefully help another mom or dad or grandma or aunt who is in charge of a little one out there. The very first thing that we started stockpiling as soon as we found out that we were pregnant was clothes. I don't know about your areas, but around here, clothes have actually been in shortage just as much as food. Like when we went to Old Navy a few weekends ago, they had only an extra small or 4X. There was nothing in between. So a lot of stores' inventory was getting very low. And one of my main concerns was not being able to clothe my child. And so we ran out right away and got quite a few clothes, and I'm still stockpiling those. An example of that is this snowsuit. When I think I was only like 8 weeks pregnant, and I ran out, and my main concern is because it's so cold here in Indiana about 9 months of the year that he would be cold. Obviously, I didn't know he was a he at the time, but the baby would be cold. So I found this snowsuit that's gender neutral, and no, I'm not going to be one of those parents that does gender neutral. I just didn't know the gender at the time. So this is just white, and it's very warm. It's fleece, and obviously it would go for a boy or a girl, and it is 6 to 9 months. So I got it bigger because my thought process on it was if we had the baby, which we're having him in July, so he shouldn't like obviously need this, but if we would have to like move or go somewhere colder, even if it was too big on him, I could put several layers on him, put him in this, and he would be nice and warm. And so that was just kind of like where my thought process was going with clothes, was I was just trying to think of different scenarios where he would need different outfits, and I just bought gender neutral clothing. Thing, though, that I'm stockpiling in his clothes right now are 12 to 24 months. So I am actually thinking 2 years ahead of time. I am stockpiling extra clothes that he can grow into because, like I said, we do have shortages. Who knows what this next year is going to bring? I mean, we're already looking at several different scenarios, and I just want to make sure, like I said, that I am able to clothe him. So we found like cute little things. These are some Carhartts. Like I said, he is a summer baby, so at 12 months he will be in the summer. So just stockpiling this stuff, and I have started to stockpile all the way up to 2 years old. So if you are looking to stockpile for your child, make sure you are buying sizes up. In fact, if you can't afford to do both, I would do the latter of doing a few years ahead, if not at least a year ahead. That way, if it's big on them, it's big on them. They can grow into it, but you know that they are, at the end of the day, going to have clothing. Obviously, to go along with clothes, we wanted them to have shoes. And this is actually our first pair of shoes that we bought. We used this in our baby announcement because we did like a camping baby announcement, and this was the closest to hiking shoes that I could find. Luckily, he is a boy, so they will work, but this will be our next item in the stockpile. But because we had one pair, I wanted to show it. But obviously, if they need clothes, they're going to need shoes on their feet. And it's so hard for me to know right now because I won't know what size he's wearing. But I definitely, obviously, babies up till 2 sometimes don't even wear shoes. So I definitely will be looking into some older pairs of shoes for him. But this is in a stockpile. Next is socks and hats. I am stockpiling socks right now. I have them up to, I think, a year. And obviously hats, because everybody knows if you are in survival that you lose most of your heat through your feet and your head. So if it was cold out, the most important thing would be to keep baby's feet and head warm. And so I think this is a very important item to stockpile in various different sizes as well. Next is another obvious one, and that is diapers and wipes. So We have been trying to buy at least one large package of diapers in every size. Obviously, babies grow out of them very quickly, so I wanted to buy a ton of them. And we are planning on doing mostly cloth diapers at home. I have them on my baby registry. Hopefully we get those at my shower. If not, I will go out obviously and purchase those. But I do think, I will say on cloth diapers, you know, this you can only use once. A cloth diaper in an SHTS situation, I think, would be way better because you can always wash it and reuse it, especially if you have them in multiple sizes. You know you're not going to run out of diapers versus this where you can't, you know, you can only use it once and then throw it away. I will say, though, having a few of these in your bug out bag in case you get separated from your loved ones so they have a way to change baby, it's fast. They don't have to worry about dealing with a cloth diaper. I think it's smart. So I think it is smart to have both, but I will say, like I said, I think the cloth diaper is more sustainable for an emergency situation. And obviously your wipes, we buy the Kirkland brand from Costco because you can get this huge like thing of it for the price of what would like three of them would be at like a normal general store. So I'm finding as far as stockpile goes for these two items, it's way cheaper to either buy them on Amazon or from a big store like Costco where you can buy them in bulk. Obviously buying in bulk is always better, and these two don't go bad. So if you are pregnant, I really highly suggest you just start stocking up at least on wipes from those places and just getting a good stockpile going. Next is formula. So I haven't decided if I'm going to fully breastfeed. I'm gonna give it a try, but we'll see how it goes. And so I have started to stockpile formula just in case, especially if something were to happen to me and my husband would be the sole provider or like another family would, I want to make sure that they have food for baby. So I've been stockpiling some different types of formulas for us to try with him. And so this is in our stockpile, and I do think it's an important item just in case. I kind of mentioned this one earlier, but the next one is blankets. We've been stockpiling lots and lots of baby blankets because this is your first defense if your heat goes out, or if your electricity goes out, is to throw a bunch of blankets on baby and keep baby warm, as well as putting hats and socks on them. So even if you don't have like a generator or anything like this, this could be a very quick way that you can keep your baby alive and keep them warm. And so we're making sure to have tons and tons of blankets for him on hand. I showed this in our bug out bag video, but I wanted to show it again. This is a baby bottle that I found that is stainless steel. I'm pretty sure you can get them on Amazon, but I did get this from a camping store. And the reason why I picked this up again is if my husband were to get separated with me, or even if I, you know, my milk dried up or I chose not to breastfeed, we would have a way to feed a baby with formula. And the nice thing about this is that it's stainless steel. So this can go over a fire. So say we were at a bug out location where all we had to purify water was a fire. We could put water in this, you know, boil it, make sure that the water is nice and free of bacteria, put the formula in, shake it up, and baby has something to eat. We also have the water filters that we are stockpiling, which is an item for both baby and us, so I thought I would mention it here. But that way we could even, you know, filter water through that, put it in this, and baby has something to eat. I just thought that this was a really good idea to give us alternative ways to feed the baby in case, you know, we weren't at home or whatever, and I have stockpiled several of these. So the next thing that we are stockpiling for baby is toys. Now this is one that we are kind of trying to wait for our baby shower to see what else we get, but I will say, let me throw it. These two right here, I found for 99 cents at the dollar store. So a lot of people, I don't know, if you don't bargain hunt, then they're probably gonna turn their nose up at this, but these are great deals. They were like seven something and they were just going out of stock, so that's why they put them on sale. So that's my tip to you, is if you are trying to stockpile for children or anything, make sure you always check clearance because you never know what you can find. This is, you know, teethers and a rattle that works perfectly fine. It's in great condition. There's nothing wrong with it. And like I said, I got it for $2. This one is a pacifier and doubles as a little stuffed animal. So I think that is great, especially we have one of these in his bug out bag because it would give him something to play with and also keep him quiet, which is very important when having a baby and on the road. I'm actually contemplating on buying him a gift like through 5 years of him being alive, just so that he has a gift on his birthday. I'm a very sentimental person, and I know that might seem like not an emergency item or whatever, but like I always want to make his birthday special, and he obviously is my priority. So like if I could stockpile away a gift that, just in case, you know, whether the economy collapses and we can't afford one in the future, or You know, we can't find it because SHTF did happen. I would always have that gift on hand to give him. And so I am a big sucker for toys. I want him to be able to have something to play with and explore and use his imagination in the future. And so toys have been on our list for him. We eventually get our homesteader even here and we're trying to, you know, just grow our own food or say his dad goes out hunting or something, or we're just trying to get stuff around here to fortify the house. You know, a toy would keep him busy as well. So I just think that it is an important item to stockpile. One of the more important items that we are stockpiling is books. I think it is so important. And no joke intended, but joke intended, if you see which book I'm holding up, society right now is attacking books greatly, and who knows what is going to go next, who knows what books they're going to promote to children. And, it is my hope to not send him to public school. I really hope to be able to homeschool him. We'll see what that happens. So I want to have a lot of books around here just to expand his imagination and so that he can learn and grow. Right along with wanting to homeschool him and books, I have started to purchase things like this. These learn to read books and these thinking skill books where it goes over like colors and like word searches and that kind of stuff. And then this one is obviously learning to read. So it does go through every single letter and has him write it out. I think the beginning is letters. So it starts out with just a single letter, and then it has like an activity to go with that and teaches them how to write that. And then the back of the book goes on to write actual words and stuff like that. So this is so, so important to me, especially in an SHTF situation where he wouldn't be going to school, where, you know, he might not even be able to have books and things. I want to make sure as his mom that he knows how to read and write and has thinking skills and gets as normal of a life as possible in that type of scenario. Some people might not see that as like an emergency thing, but to me, I think it's really important for him to have an education. And so I have started stockpiling these, so at the very least, I could teach him how to read and write. Also have been going to the dollar store almost about every week and just getting these dollar coloring books. These are so like just cheap, obviously. Just a few bucks to pick up one, two, maybe three a week, as well as crayons. So that way he has coloring books. You know, he's able to color, learn about animals, and just have an activity to do, again, if we are busy doing something around the homestead or also just for school and learning. Another learning item is this scissor skill book. I found this, again, off of Amazon, and it literally teaches kids, like, how to properly, like, cut things and gives them different activity, shows him how to cut in a straight line. And I got him these safety scissors to go along with this. So again, just another learning thing that they would learn in like preschool or something. And I also think that like it would come in handy with wilderness things, whether, you know, he needs to help dad with gutting a deer or just helping me in the garden, stuff like that. I think this could be the start of a useful skill. So I made sure to include this in his like school stuff. For his bug out bag, I actually found these activity kits. So it's little coloring pages with crayons in it, and it has little stickers, and I'm pretty sure there's like a game in here. And so these were only a dollar. Again, I found these at the dollar store, and I thought these were such a brilliant item to have in our bug out bag, so that way if we are on the move, he either has something to do while we're sitting at our site, or he has something to keep him entertained and quiet, like while we're trying to do something. Kids are very active, kids are very curious, and so I want to make sure I'm keeping his mind busy no matter what the situation is. So I just thought this would be an amazing item to share and add into his bug out bag. As of right now, that is everything that we have really thought about. Obviously, this is something we are continually thinking about, continually adding to, continually building a stockpile for our little guy. And I just hope this video was helpful. And if you have any ideas that you think I missed out, make sure that you comment them in the section down below. But that is it for today's video. Make sure you give me a big thumbs up. It's free. It only takes a second and it really helps my channel out. And I'll catch you all in the next one. Bye.